As we were still recovering from our hike the previous day, we decided to take a relaxing boat trip out to Trollfjorden with a local tour guide. So we're in Reines, just had dinner. It's about 8:45, I think it is. And we're gonna go for a drive to the town with the shortest name in the world. Called, I think it's pronounced,
It stinks.
Stinks like. So we took that short drive to the fishing village of Å, which is at the southernmost tip of the Lofoten archipelago. We explored the village on foot, which was quite nice to do. looking at the old fishermen's huts that have been converted into accommodation. So this is the place we're staying in, Sacrosoy, in Lofoten. And this is the house, the guest house we're staying in. We're staying in the attic room with the light on. A little pinhead there. This was a cloudy afternoon, but it's actually clearing up tonight, so it's about midnight now, or 10 to midnight I think it was. But it's actually clearing up, so hopefully tomorrow we'll get some nice weather.
It's a bit bright in here.
Chris is on the phone to Grace.
Hello? Straight
up.
No.
Has the same bit of coverage in Telstra?
So one of the must-do items on Lofoten is to take this hike to Kvalvika Beach and then on to the peak at Ryten. It's roughly 1.5 hours walk to Kvalvika and maybe another 30 to 45 minutes to Ryten. So I'm walking up to the Ryten peak from Kvalvika. Should take me another 10 minutes maybe. Then I've got to walk past that, or near that red shed there.
And there's people are walking down to the car. Bloody tired. I'm losing my voice. So this is Ryten. Nice view. What do you reckon, Dan? Nice. Blueberries. It's not a bad view.
At the eye of the stone statue that was erected in 1998 by English artist Anish Kapoor. And it's quite nice, but in the middle of nowhere. Thank you.
She keeps following me. I can't shake her off.